We're here in Flamingo and the southern tip of the mainland peninsula of Florida. And we're right here alongside Florida Bay. So we're right along the coast, right at sea level.
The Flamingo Visitor Center has been hit several times by hurricanes, and the whole ground floor has been flooded up to as high as 10 feet.
In 2005, at that time, it was a very vibrant community. Visitors came from around the world and year-round, but primarily during the winter dry season to really enjoy, recreate, and spend time together with their family and friends. But in the summer of 2005, we had back-to-back hurricanes. We had Hurricane Katrina in August, and then 2 months later, we had Hurricane Wilma in October. They had pretty severe winds, but the biggest piece was the storm surge tides that really damaged a lot of the infrastructure here in Flamingo.
We could have chosen not to rebuild here at all, but because of the value and the interest in this place, the access to Florida Bay, the beauty, the wildlife that is around us right now, people want to come here, and Everglades National Park wants this to be the showcase area for people to come visit once again.
We recognized that there was a good opportunity in front of us and an opportunity to rebuild and still provide many of the same visitor services, but also to be prepared and look forward into the future and really plan for climate change and purposefully decide that we could make some adjustments and adaptations and still enable people to come and enjoy, learn, and recreate.
When we started to think about rebuilding Flamingo, we intentionally thought about building it smarter, in a way that is more sustainable, that's more accessible to more people, and will be less investment in maintaining as conditions change in the future.
So one of the first things that we did was to evaluate the camping experience here in the campground. And we very intentionally decided to build these platform eco-tents. So they're raised up off the ground. This is an area that floods rather commonly, certainly on the king tides, but even on just a really good storm surge tide with a little extra rain behind it.
These eco-tents are about 100 feet from the edge of Florida Bay. So it doesn't take very much of a tide or a sea level change to flood this area. The walls are actually a canvas that we can take down when there's a storm on its way so that the water can just flow through here and not destroy these structures. So we've done that here, but we've done that also with the new cottages, with the new restaurant, and the rebuilding of the Flamingo Visitor Center.
So the ground floor of the new visitor center is going to be able to withstand the storm surge, and the utilities will be raised up. So basically, after a storm, these storm surge tides bring in mud and seagrass, a significant amount of it, and so we'll be able to take a fire hose and just hose it all down and be ready to go again. So the new lodging is repurposed steel shipping containers on cement pillars, basically. So it's raised 18 feet above ground level, and so it will be very sturdy, able to withstand a storm surge, and sustainable also into the future. So this isn't the only part of the park that's affected by sea level rise. Our west coast or Gulf Coast side of the park is also right at sea level, and so definitely seeing impacts there and the effects of sea level rise happening already. So Hurricane Irma in 2017 took out the Gulf Coast Visitor Center, but we've already been doing all this work to redevelop Flamingo and plan for the future and sea level rise and find ways to adapt our infrastructure. So we're able to take those lessons learned and apply them right here in our own park.
When it comes to rebuilding facilities along the coast, we have to be really careful and think about our investment in the long term and if it's worth the investment. Because of the resources in Everglades National Park and the recreational opportunities, we know that people want to come visit this area.
So from the eco tents to the lodging to the visitor center, we've made some smart choices around sustainability to be prepared for sea level rise, but also to continue to provide visitor services so that people can continue to learn. They can see good examples of adapting to climate change through infrastructure and continue to recreate in this beautiful place.